Welcome and thank you for joining the webinar today. I'm Amanda Jaber, the Director of Portfolio Management at Tricom. As an administrative and financial solutions provider to the staffing and consulting industry, it is our philosophy to be an active member of the staffing industry by staying abreast of the ever-changing marketplace. For that reason, Tricom was pleased to launch the Industry Insider webinar series designed to share our expert knowledge and resources with our fellow staffing industry colleagues. One of our core values is to build relationships and become a leading resource to staffing and consulting firms nationwide. Our presenter today is Lindsay Stanton, President and Board Member for Digimi, a video technology company for talent acquisition that helps organizations add new dimension to their job and employment brand messaging. In her time with the company, Lindsay has facilitated relationships with many partners, including the largest recruitment advertising agencies, global recruitment process outsourcers, and staffing firms. These partnerships magnify the organization's reach into global Fortune 1000, providing an effective and innovative solution to the largest global employers, including Kelly OCG, Adecco, TrueBlue, USG Corporation, and FedEx Express. A subject matter expert on the use of video technology as a recruitment tool, Lindsay works closely with industry leaders creating new and better ways to connect jobs and job seekers. Digimi's proprietary technology platform and the unmatched data they generate enhances Digimi's custom recruitment videos, spotlighting career opportunities and corporate culture. Digimi delivers information to job seekers in a way that is more engaging and more accessible across all platforms and devices. Their professional quality video and technology solutions include the latest cloud-based analytics, providing up-to-the-minute reporting on candidate behavior, including social sharing, as well as automatic integration into your ATS. Harness the power of video to boost SEO, improve candidate self-selection, and stand out from the competition with Digimi Video Solutions. Struggling to make placements quickly? Need help finding the right candidate? It is time to be efficient and leverage digital technology as much as possible. In today's Industry Insider webinar, Lindsay will discuss how automating your job posting, including automating a video to accompany your post in less than 48 hours, can narrow your target quickly during the recruitment process. This will reduce time to fill and even increase, even with the increase of applications. 1 minute of video is worth 1.8 million words, giving job seekers a better understanding of your roles and allowing them to better self-select prior to applying. Virtual career fairs can help bring large groups of job seekers to one virtual location, offering 1 day of chats with your recruiters. These can also serve as round one of interviews, while the day after the fair could be for scheduling round two. Efficiency is the name of today's virtual game, and we'll learn more during this presentation using real life studies. Today's learning objectives are how to use digital technology to find the right candidate, how to automate your recruitment process, why video helps show and tell your employer brand, why video helps attract and best fit for the role, and how to leverage virtual career fairs in order to be efficient for recruiting in high volume. And by the end of the session, you'll know how to amplify your recruiting efforts. If you have any questions during the presentation, please utilize our Q&A or chat features, and we'll take all the questions at the end. With that, I will turn the floor over to Lindsay.
Thank you so much. I really appreciate you having me. I'm looking forward to walking you guys through the presentation today. As many of you know, I think everybody's looking for new and innovative ways to recruit right now. Certainly, we're seeing everything move to digital over the last year plus now. We've certainly seen everything move to digital and virtual. And I think one of the things we're going to cover today is definitely how you can use digital but still keep it a high touch and very personalized in your messaging. So that's one of the learning objectives definitely for today, but looking forward to walking you through some of the results that you can expect and some of the things that I've seen even just working with our global partners on a very extensive basis across all different types of roles for all different types of customers and the impact that going digital can have regardless of job level, job type, and whether or not you can even identify the employment brand. That's actually interesting as well. So these are some of the learning objectives that we're going to touch on today. Definitely going to help you understand how you can use video, i.e. digital technology, to find the right talent, how digital actually can help increase your footprint through the talent themselves, automating the process. So I know a lot of times people think about video and they think it's going to be this big undertaking to build and develop video. It does not have to be. It actually can be automated and very fast and easy to turn up. So we're going to talk about that. And then we're going to talk about the impact to showing and telling your brand versus just having your brand in text. It does make a huge impact on learning, understanding, retention, and therefore conversion. Why video helps attract people for the right roles, and a lot of that does tie back to the technology that you're using behind the video as well as the messaging. And then how you can use virtual events to actually seamlessly tie back with video for greater efficiency, especially for high volume roles or even areas of the business where you might be struggling. I know a lot of organizations right now are trying to figure out how they can fill the positions that they have in front of them. And hopefully today, the goal is to give you tools that you can use to immediately make an impact to your business. I'm not sure if you all saw the staffing index data that came out earlier this week. And as we're all kind of feeling, there's definitely been a rise in hiring across every industry. We're seeing a rise in consumerism and activity among people, and with that comes hiring. So I think many of the organizations that we work with have seen a significant ramp, and we're helping them to instantly increase their reach and develop new video content fast so they can respond to those needs on their clients' behalf. And that's on a global scale, definitely seeing it in the US as well, but on a global scale, we're definitely starting to help organizations ramp and have been for the last few months now. So certainly a trend that I think everybody in the industry expects to continue to see. I have the pleasure of sitting on the Women in Leadership Council for the American Staffing Association. We had our big event Thrive yesterday, and I know hiring ramps and like how we can help each other from a business and networking perspective to fill positions was definitely a topic and very top of mind with the staffing firms that are part of ASA for sure, but certainly something that we continue to, you know, see on the rise month over month and even week over week as those numbers come out. So it's obviously reaching the volume of candidates that you need to reach, but it's also reaching the right candidates. And the really nice thing about doing a digital version of your job posting and even your brand is that it can really help you find the best candidates, because the candidates themselves will learn and retain so much more information, which we're going to talk about, through a video. And it doesn't have to be long. We actually track the duration of the views, both on a video jobs perspective as well as a branding perspective. And what we find is that candidates will stay engaged with a video for about 60 seconds if it's job specific. And then they will stay engaged longer if it's more company branding and cultural related. So usually you can keep them just shy of 2 minutes. So we recommend to our customers that if you're doing a branding piece, you know, keep it kind of within that sweet spot, that minute to minute and a half. But I'll go over some details as far as best practices in developing video to help you find the right candidates as we go through the slides too. But definitely we're seeing that organizations that need to hire fast,
video can definitely be a solution. If you're, you know, not reliant on your internal teams to build video, you can turn it up in as quick as 48 hours, which I'll talk about. And then certainly if you're partnering that with a video enabled virtual event, you literally can hire people on the spot. So you don't think about video as like adding time to your recruiting process. It's actually quite the opposite. It can help you build much greater efficiencies into the process. So now let's talk about how video can really kind of help you and help you find the right talent quickly. One of the things about video is it definitely can help you automate the process and it can help you streamline the candidates that you're reaching. So some of the things that have changed from a digital technology perspective is definitely related to automation. I know for companies utilizing our solution, for example, we rolled out a very simple automation that allows organizations to create unique video job ads in as quick as 48 hours. And they fit within the existing workflow and process. That's obviously huge for the recruiters because with our solution, for example, it integrates seamlessly into the applicant tracking system that the client's using, as well as any CRM tool. What's really important about that is no matter where your job postings originate, whether it's from an ATS or a posting or your careers page, any place you want them embedded into that originating environment. So typically that would be the ATS. Reason being, then every place that your job's content is getting scraped, the videos will be included. And as we'll talk about with our technology, for example, there is an intuitive social share function built into the videos themselves. So what's powerful about embedding the videos into your existing software is that software acts as a launching point, and then the videos definitely go viral after that. So you're basically enabling the candidates to do a lot of your work for you, which we'll definitely talk about, but we see, you know, huge time and cost savings as a result of that. And you can build this into your existing workflow to increase your recruiter productivity. And it helps you accelerate the time, reduce down the time to fill, accelerate the release of your jobs. And it helps you to not only reduce your time to fill, but also the cost per hire and making sure that you're reaching the right talent through that improved job profile right out of the gate. And then if you're using automation across your recruitment process, definitely, you know, doing things like simplifying scheduling through automation tools of your jobs themselves, helping you recruit on the go. We're seeing a lot of organizations begin to pipeline more and more for talent. So integrating a CRM into your process and implementing evaluation of your process. So one thing that we always recommend, and certainly I would say this is now a good time to do it, is kind of test, walk through the process of finding your jobs online and going through the application process so that you can see how it actually works. I think sometimes we kind of get caught in our day-to-day and we might lose sight of what actually the candidates are going through procedurally. And I'll talk about some of the best practices as far as communication to candidates in a few slides, but definitely I suggest walking through that workflow and from the candidate side of the desk and understanding what they're going through to find your jobs and apply for them, because that can really help you to find opportunities to do a better job, but also it can actually help you identify opportunities around where you could have better automation and kind of plug in some of the gaps in the process that way too. So going through that process can be extremely informative and help you understand both from a recruiter's perspective as well as a job seeker's perspective. One of the really nice things about as far as increasing efficiency that video jobs offer is they increase self-selection tremendously. So one of the unique things, not only as we mentioned in the lead-in, not only can you fit a ton of content in a 60-second window, but you can also really help arm the candidate with all the information they need to self-select in or out based on fit. So the candidates will learn and retain about 70% more of the job requirements when they're looking and watching a video job ad versus, I always say reading in air quotes, because I feel like nobody reads the whole job description anymore. So that you're obviously having a tremendous impact on self-selection when you are increasing the learning and retention that much. And we always suggest incorporating, obviously you want the video job to be specific to a role. We recommend, and you'll see it ties back to social very strongly, but we recommend as kind of a best practice to not only keep it job specific, but also identify the hiring market to optimize conversion, and it also optimizes social performance as well. So doing things like that can have a tremendous impact because the candidates will see that it's a relevant job for them, but it's also a relevant job in the market that they are in or desire to work in. So those are just a couple best practices, but I'll talk a little bit more about how that ties back to social too. Obviously, when you're talking about increasing learning and retention that much, you certainly are minimizing the amount of time associated with screening by phone, or some of our clients will link their video jobs to an AI tool or even a video interviewing tool, video screening tool. So certainly, you know, the more you're creating a workflow like that and kind of automating and maybe even creating some knockouts along the way, you're going to make sure that you're increasing your recruiter efficiency even more. Couple ways that we automate on the video job side, we have two ways that we create content for our clients. We do have a full scale production team. And even when we're doing things like absorbing brand assets and working heavily with client brand on the enterprise side, like for the FedExes of the world, we can turn around and build a unique video library for a client in about a week and a half. So it's pretty efficient considering it's, you know, robust and customized video content. But on the automated side, we have a solution that we call DigiMate, and it literally does automate the entire process. So within hours, we can turn up unique video job ads for a customer that automatically get embedded into their posting and go viral. So I know I'm like talking a lot about creating the process fast in automation, but I know everybody's business at this point depends on filling those positions because they're absolutely critical to the organization. And so I can't reiterate enough that do not view video as something that's going to be a lot of work to create or time consuming, because it definitely can, you know, help you very efficiently and very quickly to get your positions out there and reaching the right candidates fast. And then with virtual events, you can literally embed the videos right into the platform. We have a video enabled virtual events platform that we can stand up within hours to help clients with heavy volume recruiting needs or even just ongoing needs where their recruiters can actually do a live screening and interview of a candidate right from the event, as well as the candidates being able to view their video content to self-select and deepen their knowledge base before they even engage in a conversation with the recruiter. So again, helping from an efficiency perspective. So video obviously is a great way to show and tell your story, but it's very, very critical to tie that back to data. So one of the totally unique aspects of DigiMe, and something that I'm really proud of having been at the organization since 2008, is we are one of the unicorns, I guess you would say, of the talent tech space, and the fact that we have a patent around our video player itself, which covers all of the tracking and data, as well as the functionality and the options that it provides to candidates. So every video job we create for a client has a social share button on it, as well as an apply button. Those are really important because it allows us to help our clients build a story around the candidate data, understanding where they're finding you to begin with, where they're interacting with you, when they're interacting with you, and what is that leading to? What conversion is that driving by source? So for example, through our live dashboard, our clients can find out exactly where they're filling their jobs, how they're filling their jobs, and when they're filling their jobs their best. It gives you extremely important data to help your business grow fast, and creates extreme efficiencies and helps you from a strategy perspective. So it's a big driver behind why we are working with so many staffing and RPO firms on a global scale, because they're in there looking at that data and leveraging it to help their business every single day. And one of the things that the video does, it allows you to go viral. So you're reaching a high volume and more candidates quickly, but the data helps you streamline where you're actually seeing the best conversions, so that where the candidates are taking you is the place that your recruiters are going also. So for example, with our apply button, we can actually see down to the specific source where a client's getting the best conversion. And without a doubt, the social share button is the largest way that our clients are getting traffic to their jobs. It's the highest driver of video job views. It's the highest driver of video job applications, the best converter, and then always within the top three sources for conversion to hire as well. So definitely that is super important to mention, because that social share button is actually candidate driven. So while it's great when organizations are actively implementing and leveraging a social strategy, a paid social strategy actually will typically underperform an organic candidate driven result day in and day out. So it's very interesting, and that's across all job types, whether we're hiring for a senior software engineer or if we're hiring an hourly role for a forklift driver. We see that across the board, that candidate-driven activity, organic social activity, outpaces the pay-for social activity by far. And with the data, we can get super granular for our clients, so they can understand exactly like a specific Twitter hashtag or Facebook group that's driving the best traffic to their jobs. So that's really important. And it also helps from an automation perspective. So we help them to understand the time of day and the day of the week that candidates are engaging best with their content. Couple things that are pretty universal we see across clients is Tuesdays and Thursdays are generally the best days of the week to release your jobs. So again, back to the automation, with that data, you know, you can know that those are the times that you should set your jobs to release, Tuesdays and Thursdays across the board. And then during the workday, always the best performer. Pretty much across the board, all clients, all locations, we see the weekends as the worst performer. And it's kind of interesting. My theory on why Tuesday and Thursday is, I think people have had their workday on Monday. They got frustrated enough with, you know, their boss or their situation to start looking on Tuesday. Thursday, they're kind of, you know, at the end of the week, they're frustrated. They might be thinking about where else they could go. So I think those 2 days we see across the board with our clients are the best performers by far. Certainly the data is, you know, always going to give you nuances based on the types of jobs that you're filling and the locations you're filling them in. The results in a very, very rural location in the US, for example, will have very different results than, you know, a major city. It's interesting, another trend that we've tracked across our clients' jobs is when we are helping clients in rural markets, which, you know, a good amount of clients have positions in rural markets, whether it's, you know, warehouse, manufacturing, but we definitely see that mobile adoption is very high in those rural locations. But it's interesting to track mobile as well, because sometimes those trends can surprise you. And for some jobs and some markets, mobile adoption is actually super low, and it surprises you. But for other positions, you know, it might be 90% of your traffic. So that's again where the data and walking through the process kind of together can be very, very important, because certainly if you see, you know, 90% of your traffic is coming in through mobile, but you've got, you know, challenging hurdles around the mobile process, whether it's viewing the jobs mobilely, which all of our videos are mobile enabled and mobile tracked, or if it's, you know, a challenge with the ATS, you know, maybe you need to do some things to augment the process, because certainly, especially right now, you know, you don't want to throw up any additional hurdles in the process that might prevent a candidate from completing that application. So, but understanding the data, where you're getting the best views, applications, and then ultimately hires, even from a social perspective, if you're using the right data provider behind your digital job ads, you certainly are allowing that viral aspect and the fact that the videos do get spread out so easily, so quickly, to do you a huge favor, because now you've got a great story and data mapping to help you, you know, point your recruiters in the right direction as far as where they should be spending their time and where they should be spending their efforts. So go into mobile a little bit more. I definitely always feel that, and the data shows us this, that video, mobile, and social play extremely well together. Excuse the pun of the word play, but you definitely are enabling the candidates to share your content easily and quickly. We've even done some specifically targeted videos for social, especially like in the retail or hospitality sector, where they might be, you know, a 30-second video or a 20-second video versus a full 60-second job video, just to get people engaged. So a lot of times it's that hook, right, to even pull them into why they should consider your organization and your position opening. So that's great. That works out really, really well when you're thinking about social particularly. And sometimes you can even create like a social hook that links to a full job video. We've done that for customers as well. Just keep in mind, like, you can co-link videos together. So we will always co-link our client's brand story with their job specific videos. That helps tremendously, not only with candidates learning and understanding, it can be great from a diversity and inclusion initiative perspective, but it also can help you tremendously from a search engine optimization perspective as well. So we'll talk about that too, but the videos have a tremendous SEO impact, and when you layer them on top of each other and co-link them, it increases it even more. So, but you know, the great thing about the videos is they are mobily accessible. We actually track the type of device that candidates are coming in from, so that you know exactly how many of your jobs are actually being accessed by mobile versus not. And it can help you tell your story in a short way that's easy for the candidates to spread the messaging. And then if you are, you know, doing an effective job of getting the word out there initially, which can be very simple, just a matter of putting that code into your ATS, then the candidates will, you know, help share the messaging for you. So social sharing, I really can't talk about this enough, because it is just such a tremendous driver of traffic across our client base, again, on a global scale. So Social doesn't have to be a lot of work. Matter of fact, as I mentioned, since organic does outpace the pay-per-click so much, it can be a really efficient and affordable way to fill your clients' job openings. If you're telling your story in a great dynamic way, whether it's your jobs or your brands, you really don't have to do the heavy lifting. The candidates will do that for you. So one thing that we've helped organizations with is using social media to help improve their brand reputation. So whether it's, you know, a staffing firm that maybe candidates don't recognize or they don't understand what their role would be in the recruiting process, or even a large, heavily recognized brand that maybe combats issues from a social perspective, you can use the videos to basically increase your position and outweigh any negative messaging that might be out there about you. So we've actually seen that organizations that struggled with negative messaging used their career opportunities as a way to kind of outshine the negative messaging and tell their story in a positive way that allowed for candidate engagement and candidate sharing. So you do remember that the candidates are researching you, especially right now. They're researching your brand, they're researching your reputation. But I wouldn't worry too much if, you know, you're an unrecognized brand. That's okay. And I think that's even a bigger, better reason to sell your story in video, because you can tell them all the unique aspects of your organization and why they would want to work there. It definitely creates a level of authenticity and credibility behind the organization, allows you to highlight things that maybe are really unique and not typically thought of when you're thinking about, you know, recruiting and how to sell your story. I would get as creative as you want to. We've done some pretty amazing stories for our customers, and that can be even just like your role in the recruitment process. So I know the candidates get very confused about, you know, we as an industry understand obviously what staffing's role is, what RPO's role is, but the candidates really don't understand that. They kind of struggle even just with the basic information of like how long it's going to take us to review their resume. They don't know that it's going to take us 4 to 6 weeks to do that. So anything you can do to help educate them as to, you know, how you're advocating on their behalf and the uniqueness of your process and how it works, and keeping it as high touch as possible, is really important. So what we see is organizations keeping that video messaging consistent throughout the process, touching them with the cultural video, touching them with the job video, reaching out to them post-apply with a short message about, okay, here's what you should expect next. And then an engagement video. So, you know, as they're making their way through the recruiting process, just, you know, retouching them with maybe another message about company culture or, you know, the team that's going to be hiring them, different aspects like that, that just keep that engagement high. You can, again, it kind of goes back to what I mentioned at the beginning. You can be very high touch without having to be high touch. So use the videos to help you kind of sell your story. From a social perspective, we definitely see that our clients get a tremendous amount of results, not just even broadly across social, but certainly whenever they're tying back location. So I mentioned this before, but one of the things that we see is if you're hiring for the same role in a variety of locations, that's fine. That can be very easy to turn up the videos in multiple markets within minutes. So for example, if we're hiring for a courier role for one of our clients or a CDL driver role for one of our clients, and they're hiring for it in 200 different markets, we can build that CDL role once, but we can duplicate it and do some unique things from an SEO perspective with the meta tags. We can link the apply button specific to requisition by location. And then we are able to really help them to understand where they're getting the candidates by market. So one of the lead sources that we see across our client bases is client bases definitely with like Facebook groups and Twitter hashtags, where we're specifically targeting individual locations, and those tend to get really great conversion. So one of the nice things is, like, once you push out to a Facebook group, and we help our clients, we've got distribution into over 500 of them, but once you post into one of those groups, the videos tend to go viral from there. So that's an additional sharing point that helps get the traffic going and kicked off for companies. And then in the data, you're gonna see how that performed. The other fun thing that we have seen clients take advantage of that's driven a ton of results with social is making competition with your recruiters. So we have the ability to do, for example, a custom source tag, which is basically like a unique identifier for each recruiter on the videos. So they can run contests and they can see, you know, okay, you know, Liz had like, you know, 1,000 shares off of the video that she posted on a Facebook group this week, and Sarah had 500, and it all builds on itself. But you can do some really cool things, you know, with motivation and generating excitement among your recruiters when they can see the results, especially being able to see the impact that they're having from a social perspective so quickly. And the one thing that we recommend is, in order to make sure your videos are easily socially digestible and mobily digestible for that matter, is to keep them short. So we do track duration of candidate view, and we do typically see that about 60 seconds is kind of the sweet spot. So usually candidates will stay on for about 57 to 60 seconds, which is right when the logo for our clients pops on the screen. So we definitely see that. And that's kind of the where you want to sit from a length of time perspective. So we're oftentimes helping clients reuse or re-leverage the content that maybe marketing created that's a little bit too long for candidates to stay engaged. So that's a really great way to keep them engaged, is making sure that you're telling your story in a shorter time frame. So you can keep it condensed and still get all your messaging across, because you can communicate one minute of video is worth 1.8 million words. So that's a lot of content. And honestly, there's so much redundancy in most organizations' job descriptions anyways, you can typically cut it down to a pretty short duration. So anywhere from 30 seconds to a minute, and you're able to communicate your core values and the position opening. We typically see that kind of a great way to create the video job ads is kind of wedge the core information about the position itself in the middle. So all those job specific requirements, whether it's, you know, heavy lifting, certification, certain education, all that information is great in the middle of the video, and use the front end and the back end of the video, so the opening and closing, to kind of sell your story as an organization. So basically mini cultural content, whether it's just a few sentences about what differentiates you, again, kind of to act as a hook so that you're bringing the candidates in, and they understand company culture very quickly, and then they understand the core requirements of the job, all leading to better self-selection and deeper engagement. The other thing that video is, you know, huge for is SEO. So Google, for instance, as you probably know, recognizes and gives priority to video content over text-based content. So you can really use that to your advantage. We see the SEO getting boosted by 53 times when clients are implementing video job ads. And it's interesting, we've run some really awesome case studies around impact as clients have increased the amount of video job ads on their career site. So we've got organizations who have thousands of jobs, especially, again, same core job, but they're running it in, you know, maybe 1,000 different markets, and the impact that it has on SEO and keywords. We had one client who we did an in-depth SEO review for, and they had off of one of their main roles that they hire for by in the hundreds of thousands every year, they had over 109 keywords driving them, driving results for the first page of a search for a candidate. So that has a tremendous impact on not only helping them reach candidates quickly, but also self-selection and making sure it's the right candidates, because they're typing in keywords that are relevant to that organization and the roles that that organization has. So they tend to be better converting candidates. So the more you're increasing the usage of video, the more you're adopting it on your career site, the more you're pulling in traffic. And what's really cool about it is you're pulling that traffic into you versus pushing it out to an outside vendor or source. So because the videos are embedded right into your postings, you're driving that traffic to yourself. And then that SEO can act as a launch point for your social. So the candidates will find you on Google and they'll view your job ad. Maybe it's not the right position for them, but they can easily share it out to their network and the videos go viral from there. So I want to talk about kind of next in the presentation, helping with challenges around ghosting. So I know this has become such a challenge for so many organizations, and it's really only gotten worse with COVID, and in the last 12 months, we've seen it on the rise because people are scared to make a move. And with fear comes, basically just lack of information. And so communication is so key to helping eliminate ghosting. And one of the things that we launched for our clients a little over a year ago was a candidate expectation video, which is basically a short video helping explain to the candidate what they should expect next in the process. Typically, these are delivered automatically post-apply to the candidate after they hit that, application button in the ATS and complete the apply process. But it's just when you're thinking about what you're going to communicate, you want to think about, number one, creating a rapport, keeping it clear, keeping it concise, and making sure it's specific. So sometimes, like, we'll do one version for the field operations team of an organization, but a different version for the corporate team, for example, because sometimes those processes can look completely different. So setting the expectation of when they should expect to hear from you, what they should expect to hear from you, and building that rapport and that relationship. When we work with staffing firms, we've oftentimes tied back their role in the process, again, kind of letting the candidates know that they're acting as the advocate on their behalf, because that can be very confusing, and it just keeps that consistency. So they've learned and understood that through the staffing firm's cultural message, but then they're getting reiterated the process and the role that they're playing as they view the video around what's gonna happen next too. When you're thinking about post-apply messaging, this can be even shorter than your job messaging, because you're really just trying to communicate to them the key facts of what they should expect. So we usually see these run anywhere from 20 to 40 seconds in length. So you can get, again, quite a bit of information across in a relatively short time frame. And I'll just cover this slide very quickly, but it definitely goes to the ghosting thing and the ghosting challenge. When you think about having your needs met, obviously, changing employers can you make you feel unsafe. It can make you question your self-esteem. It can make you distressed. So I think being able to communicate your messaging in a way that helps create confidence in the candidate's decision-making process, making them feel comfortable with the work environment, with the company culture, with the job details, with the benefits, with the process, all creates a better, safer feeling for the candidate side, and keeps them sticking with the process. Again, you're building that rapport, but you're building that confidence to help them, keep going, and understanding that you are trying to help them and that you're acting as their advocate. So you can communicate so much of that in the video messaging to help them understand that. And then if you're looking to ramp really fast, integrating any video content that you have into a video-based virtual event, the virtual events we run can be turned up instantly. We do all the heavy lifting, building out the booths, the branding, all that. You can engage in live chat, both text-based as video, as well as video chat. So you can actually interview somebody on the spot. They can apply for a job right there through the chat feature. An application can be sent back and forth, a resume. And then, of course, all the videos that we would create can be integrated into the platform too. So the candidates actually can preview the organization and self-select before they even have a chat with a recruiter. So that's, I know, helping a lot of organizations with their hiring ramps. They'll set a date. We've even had companies do multiple booths for locations. So you can certainly do multiple clients within an event, but you can also, we have standing events with FedEx, and they'll do all their different distribution centers will have their own booths. So it gives them flexibility to be able to accommodate those hiring ramps and make sure that they're talking to a high volume of candidates and getting great engagement and pre-screening them right at the event itself. So last but not least, before we do Q&A, I'll walk you guys through just a couple of case studies. I would mention we literally have case studies at this point for every industry, every type of role, and we've covered every language, I think, out there at this point. Many of our global clients need positions in a variety of languages, but I think the case studies just really go to show the impact from a social perspective and how fast you can expect results with video. So because the candidates are driving so much of the activity, you can see this particular client for these warehouse positions had a very heavy usage from the candidate's social sharing, from Facebook, from Career Builder, but they had great results, great conversion, and high adoption with their videos in a very short amount of time. And what's nice is the videos will continue to go viral as they're out on the web too. So sometimes we'll do annual refreshes for clients, but they will continue to go viral because the code behind them always stays the same, which is nice. Healthcare is a huge one where we've had a lot of success with our clients. Really quick hiring ramps, especially with some of the Facebook group targeting that we've been able to do for our customers. We had one client who within a 3-week time frame hired 70 RNs and CNAs primarily through social. So again, if you're like this, one of the groups that their video ended up in had over 110,000 nurses in it, and that led to a huge conversion for them, but also then the data showed them the story of here's where we should be posting our videos out to. So the data not only is driving results from a hiring perspective, but continuing to add efficiencies and effectiveness to the process. So I know I covered a lot of information in a relatively short time frame, but I do want to open it up for questions.
So at this time, you can go ahead and submit any questions you have in the Q&A or chat feature. And Lindsay, while we're waiting for some questions to come in, can you cover briefly what some of the top questions you typically get as you're discussing this with clients?
Yeah, absolutely. Probably the one I get the most is around what type of job this works best for. And it's really interesting because it works well for every type of position. It's just a matter of the sites that are going to perform based on the job title, if that makes sense. So where we might see Craigslist or organic Facebook perform really well for like an hourly role, We might see like LinkedIn and LinkedIn InMails perform really, really well for, you know, a senior level position. So, but again, the data kind of shows them that story. That's one we get asked a lot. And then another one that we get asked quite a bit is around the process, because I think there is this feeling that video is going to be a lot of heavy lifting to implement. And the process is as simple as us getting a written job description, and then our team will do the rest. We can leverage any assets that the client wants to send our way. Typically that's done through like a Dropbox. Like our staffing clients typically just send us the job description and their logo, and then our team does all the rest. So it really can be as simple and as turnkey as a job description and a logo.
And who's typically doing the video for the staffing client?
Yeah, really great question. So we are. So we've got thousands of hours of vertical related footage that we will use to create the video itself. And then we have professional talent that will do the voiceover, which we can do in any language or accent that the client prefers. But yeah, typically we're building it.
Fantastic.
We do have within our dashboard, there is a user generated option. But I know I would say that like that's the exception versus the rule. Most organizations want that professional, more produced content, especially since it does go so viral. They want to put their best foot forward when, you know, pushing something out through the World Wide Web.
Certainly, yeah. And I'm sure it also helps with the amount of time that they would need to put into it if they're not having to create the video themselves.
For sure. Especially, I mean, a lot of people are actually pretty adverse to being on camera too. So when do you force a recruiter to go in front of a television screen or a video camera and record something? You might get resistance. So yeah, so they'd rather have us do all the heavy lifting, just send us the job description, and then we go from there.
Wonderful. Another question that has come in is it's related to you had made a comment about posting in different groups. Who makes the group selections?
Yeah, so typically we do to start with. It's kind of a dual process. So we give the tool to, we give the video code to our clients. So certainly if they're using social to recruit, they can do that. But we initiate placements in groups just to help our clients, you know, kick off strong to begin with. And that's done through our dedicated customer support team who will, you know, specifically target groups based on customer and job types. We are tracking the data from the candidate side too. So a lot of times they'll, you know, kind of help pull us and the client in, you know, in a certain direction where they're getting the best conversion.
Wonderful. Well, I don't see any additional questions that have come in so far, but if you do have any questions that you would like to connect with Lindsay directly, her contact information is on the screen. I'm sure she would be happy to connect one-on-one with anyone. And as we're going ahead here and wrapping up today's session, if you have any final thoughts, otherwise you can also contact me directly. I'm happy to share the information, the PowerPoint slides for you if you would like to review the content further. We will also post a recording on TrackCom's website if you'd like to revisit or share with other individuals within your organization.
Thank you so much for having me.
Thank you for taking the time to join us and to cover the Amplify Your Recruiting Efforts by Riding the Digital Wave. Watch for information on our next webinar session. And thank you all so much for joining us. Have a great day.
Bye.